Now we are discussing about a new topic, that is patents. What are patents? The word patent originates from a Latin word called patere, which means to lay open or to make available a thing for public inspection. Literally, it is an exclusive monopoly which is granted by the government into the inventor over his invention for a limited period of time. In modern usage, we can say that this patent is usually referring to the whole right which is given into the inventor by the government, the inventions either as a new, useful and non-obvious process, machines or article of manufacture or composition of matter before the public. Okay. The person who is receiving this patent is called a patentee. I will cite you with an example. What is Bluetooth? You know that Bluetooth is an electronic device. Or a certain application, this is generally concerned with the exchanging information for mobile communication devices, right? Then solar panel. Here the patent name is described as the apparatus for utilizing this solar radiant energy. So all these kinds of inventions can be treated as a patent. And other type of it is actually is coming under the IPR. What is IPR? That is intellectual property right. In some jurisdictions, in accordance with the industry where the patent is generally given, it is named as design patents and plan patents. Design patents means it is the patents which is invented in some industrial application, and plan patent means the patents which is generally given in the field of plant taxonomy, plant breeding. And in accordance with the field in which the patent is granted, there are generally three different types of patents are seen. They are called utility patents, design patents and plant patents. What are they? Utility patents means here the patent is granted to anyone who invents or discovers any new and useful process, either a machine or an article of manufacture or a composition of matter or any another new useful improvement thereof. This is generally categorized in the utility patent. Then what is meant by design patent? If a person is generally inventing a new, original and ornamental design for an article or a manufacturer, it is called a design patent. So here the patent is generally provided by the discovery of a new design. Then plan patents, here the patent is granted to anyone who invents or discover any sexually reproducing organism or plant and any distinct and new variety of plant. So in the field of plant, if there occurs any discoveries or ideas or new findings, we are providing the plan patents. Then what about the things? What kind of invention what will be the nature of the invention that can be patented? The invention should be novel, non-obvious and should be having some industrial application. When an invention possesses these three characteristics, that particular invention can be patented. What cannot be patented? If the invention or the finding is an artistic creation, or it is a mathematical methods, or it is a business schemes, or if it is having anything which is against the universal law, cannot be patented. Okay, so whenever all these things happens, we cannot provide the patentee. Then how we get a patent? What are the different stages to obtain a patent? The first step is filing or filling an application for the patent. We need to, there is an application form is available for the for providing the patent. So we have to fill up this application form, and this application form is required to be filled or to be filed according to the territory limited. Territory means in which area this patent is coming. For more clearly, where the applicant or the first mentioned applicant in the case of joint applicants, or for a patent which is normally reside or has a domicile or has a place of business or the place from where the invention is actually originated. That is very much important. That is called territory limit. So we have to specify this territory limit into the application form. In India, there are four patent offices are located respectively in Kolkata, Mumbai, Delhi and Chennai. There will be an examination regarding this invention. That is the examination. Before examination, we need to request or we need to write a request for the exam. Okay, so early request for the exam. No application for patent will be examined if no request is made by the applicant or by any interested for person in Form 18 whether prescribed free of ₹2,500 or ₹10,000 for natural person and other than natural persons respectively, which means we need to remit a prescribed fee of this to into the patent office. Otherwise, our application will not be examined. We need to make the request along with this prescribed fee. Then, after sending the application form, there will be the examination report. It will be done by the patent office. The first examiner report, which is stating the objections or the requirements. If the report, if the application, the request, or the invention is devoid of anything, there will be an objection. Okay, so the report will be stating the objections or requirements, which will be all these things, either it is an objection or it is a requirement. It will be communicated to the applicant according to the address he has applied within the 6 months from the date of request. So I told you that before going to the examination, the applicant has to file an application form along with the prescribed fee. If that report, after examining that report, if it requires any kind of requirements or any kind of objection, it will be that all these things will be communicated into the applicant within 6 months. Okay, after 6 months, if there is no such objections, the patent will be granted to the patentee. And it will be valid from the date of publication under section 11A. And what about the validity? The validity of every patent will be 20 years from the date of filing of this patent application. And the date of the patent is the date on which the application for the patent is getting filed. Then what about the rights of a patentee? Patentee, by providing patents, the patentee gets exclusively all right to his inventions. And apart from that, the government gets the right to publish the full invention of this patentee. By means so, this patentee is able to exploit its invention and have the exclusive monopoly to take the legal action against the infringers. So these are the rights which is generally attributed to a patentee when a patent is granted. So that's all about the introduction of patents. And if you have any doubt, please do in the comment section. Thank you.